The following program is a production of HEW Entertainment and contains views, opinions, commentaries, and content that may offend some subscribers of this show. Listener discretion is advised.
People always ask me, Jonathan Clark, how do you become famous overnight? Okay, are you watching? This is how. You're over my head, I'm out of my mind, thinking I was wrong in the wrong time. It's like I'm rewind, everything is so throwbacky. So, what did you think? Hey guys, it's your favorite YouTube video blogger, Jonathan Clark, streaming another video for you on youtube.com/JonathanClark22. And in the middle of the COVID-19 pandemic with over 21 million cases worldwide, I've had the chance to catch up on a lot of WWE and their production from the WWE Performance Center of Raw, NXT, and SmackDown. I think they're doing an incredible job with that to kick off my show this week. Nothing seems to stop Vince McMahon and his global empire from still captivating millions of fans worldwide, transmitting Raw, NXT, SmackDown, 205 Live, the WWE Network. It's just absolutely phenomenal what they're doing with what they have to work with during this pandemic. Of course, they have canceled all live events, all major Raw, SmackDown, NXT, 205 Live, and every WWE taping opportunity. They are still producing their pay-per-views from the Performance Center. And, you know, I think that it's great how they're doing the best they can to still provide us with storylines that still keep us guessing what's going to happen from one episode to the next. There is a reason why Raw and SmackDown are two of the longest running episodic weekly television TV series in history, and if you haven't already figured that out, you should probably watch WWE. We've seen everything from the Money in the Bank ladder match for both the Raw and the Women happen together and actually allow them to go to the top of WWE headquarters to capture the opportunity to wrestle for the WWE Championships and the Women's Championship. The actual women's match this year was actually four. The vacated Raw Women's Championship after Becky Lynch went public with her pregnancy, which I would like to congratulate her about. We've seen a swamp match between Bray Wyatt and The Fiend and Braun Strowman, which was the last thing that I ever thought I would see at the Extreme Rules Horror Show. And now we're getting ready for SummerSlam, where we're going to see Randy Orton and Drew McIntyre headline the event. We saw the greatest wrestling match ever between Edge and Randy Orton, years in the making, after, of course, their history as rated RKO, which is their history in general, over titles like the Intercontinental Championship. I also really appreciate how they've gotten slogans for the pay-per-views thrown in there, like Backlash, the greatest wrestling match ever, Extreme Rules Horror Show, SummerSlam's got you're never going to see it coming. They're doing seemingly everything possible to get us talking, and I really appreciate that, because they could be like Impact Wrestling or Elite Wrestling, where we're just seeing repeats of shows that have already aired. But they're not doing that. They are not stopping producing the shows, and they are doing it in front of minimized audiences, which is great too. They even got people from the Performance Center playing the role of fans in the crowd, which I really appreciate, because again, they could be doing it in front of just an empty arena. Like Stone Cold Steve Austin said back on Austin 316 Day, he didn't care if it was in front of fans or there were no fans in the crowd, he was still going to raise hell like he had done for years. I think it's just amazing how WWE doesn't stop for anything. They're not going to allow anything to stop them. And I think one of the biggest reasons we have to take into consideration why they're working with what they've been given is because WWE can't pause the storylines. They can't pick up where they left off leading into WrestleMania by, say, next year, this time in October. They're not going to be able to do that. We have to have a year-round champion. We have to have a champion for each respective division. We have to have storylines that have to keep on going. And we have to keep moving on as if there's no COVID-19, no coronavirus, no infections, no global pandemic, and we have to get to a point where WWE fans are still getting what they've been getting for years and come to accustomed to, we all have as wrestling fans. I never thought 20 years ago when I first started watching wrestling, I'd be watching wrestling in the middle of a global pandemic, like we are. And we'd be faced with the situation that we are. We've seen several wrestlers come down with COVID-19, have to go in quarantine because of traveling issues and different circumstances that have befallen them. We saw the Roman Reigns Goldberg match at WrestleMania this year, with all the promotion it received, be put on the back burner because of the COVID-19 pandemic. We're seeing wrestlers not wanting to wrestle in an empty arena in the performance center, like Brock Lesnar. We haven't seen him since WrestleMania, so there's a lot happening. With the restrictions, with the guidelines that we have to abide by, but millions of people are still being entertained, and I really appreciate that from both the men's and women's divisions and the respective divisions that apply to both men and women in the WWE. No matter if you're from Raw, SmackDown, the brands, NXT, 205 Live, you're doing a phenomenal job. And in due time, I think we're going to see the resumption of live shows and live house shows, live events, which they are definitely losing a lot of money and grossing a lot on because of how they can't do them anymore. It's a different world for wrestling fans, but I think we're getting used to it. They say it's going to be for the foreseeable future. There's information available on WWE.com, and in terms of a 5-star scale perspective rating, I know I haven't done one of these in a long time. I have to go 3 out of 5 stars, taking 2 away from how they're limited to producing the shows like we've become accustomed to for at least the last 15 to 20 years. All the generations we've seen wrestling go through, especially in WWE, we have never been faced with circumstances quite like this or an era. I think this is going to be called the COVID-19 era, the pandemic era, if you would. But it's just phenomenal. We're still seeing great things happen, like Becky Lynch, of course, just recently announcing her pregnancy, taking time away from WWE to go home to be a mom. We're seeing Edge returning to the ring, probably not under the circumstances that he wanted to return to the ring for WrestleMania this year, entering the Royal Rumble match. It's one of those surprise legendary entrances. It's obviously not the way he wanted to return. Obviously, a reunion of E&C is coming up to Edge and Christian because of the attack by Randy Orton on Christian. We're going to be seeing that. It's a shame it has to all happen in the COVID-19 pandemic, but it is what it is, and I think WWE are doing just a phenomenal job with that. So I thought I would put this together for a video on my YouTube channel. If you want to contribute anything in the way of comments, you can feel free to do so at the bottom of this video in the comments section. Let me know how you're coping with the COVID-19 pandemic and how wrestling is being produced, and if you're kind of satisfied with what wrestling is giving us, or you feel you're in that group of individuals, that significantly large group of individuals will probably think that, wrestling could be offering us more. I know there are people out there that are satisfied with it, extremely satisfied with it, but there are people out there wanting more, desperately always scratching at the surface for more. And obviously, there can be more offered, but WWE is doing a great job of what they have to work with because they could have stopped production. They could have halted it all. But they took the production trucks, they took the sets, they moved them to the Performance Center under the most dire of circumstances, literally weeks before WrestleMania back in March. This was all put to a halt, but WWE didn't slow down, they didn't stop, and they're still doing it as if we're not faced with a COVID-19 pandemic. And just TV shows and movies and production of all this that was put on the back burner for months is only just resuming now in the summer of 2020, and WWE didn't slow down for anyone or any particular reason, and I think they deserve all the credit in the world. I'm satisfied with it. I'm in the group of individuals who are satisfied with it. I don't know how you feel about it, but it is what it is, and we will get through it. And we will see a resumption of things in WWE back to normalcy. When I don't know, but we will see it in the very near future. They're saying it's going to be for the foreseeable future, but stranger things have happened. And as they've said many times over the years, anything can happen in the WWE. And I think 2020 is a surefire example of just that. I'm your host, Jonathan Clark, and I will check in with you again really soon. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel, and I will see you really soon. So long for now.
HEW Entertainment Radio is a production of HEW Entertainment on their official website and broadcasts on social media. You can join the conversation on our Facebook page at HEW Entertainment, follow and listen to our show on Twitter at JonathanClark1, and watch us on our YouTube channel at JonathanClark22. Hosted and produced by Jonathan Clark out of Canada, if you have any questions on our radio broadcast, you can email us at JonathanClark2005@hotmail.com. Thank you for listening.